Today's topic is very, very important. It is related to the definitions of thermodynamics, then differential equations of thermodynamics, then Maxwell relations. They are very, very important from the examination point of view. Now, first of all, we have to draw a picture like this. Picture in this square box, we have S, P, V and T. What is S? S is entropy, P is pressure, T is temperature, V is volume. So first we have to remember this square box. Now how to remember this? You can say smart people, very talented. Smart people, very talented. So this square box is related to that. Now one more square box is there. H is in between S and P, G is in between P and T, A is in between V and T, U is in between S and V. That means, what it means? H is a natural function of S and P. G is a natural function of P and T. A is a natural function of V and T. U is a natural function of S and V. H is enthalpy, G is Gibbs free energy, U is internal energy and A is Helmholtz free energy. What is that? Helmholtz free energy. Now, let's take an example. We are deriving relation between U and H. So, while going from U to H, you should go diagonally. See, U to H, to go diagonally we go like this. So U to H and P to H. Now when we go from U to V to P to H, while going from this to this, we go up. So it is, relation is U plus PV. If arrow goes up, then it is plus sign. If arrow goes down, then it is minus sign. So U plus PV is equal to H. Or we can derive like H PV to U. When we go from H to U, arrow goes down. So it can be written as H minus PV equal to U. Both are same. So this is your first relation between H and U. Now come to second. Let us take an example. We are deriving relation between G and H. When we go from G to H diagonally we go like this. It is like this. Now if we go from G to H, then we go up, that has positive sign. If we go from H to G, we go down. So it is equal to H. As arrow goes down, that means negative sign, H minus TS equal to G. Or if we go from G to H, then it is G plus TS equal to H. Because if we go from G to H, arrow goes up. Okay. Now next relation between U and A. So while deriving relation between U and A, diagonally we go like this. Now U to A. So when we go from U to A, it is U minus TS equal to A, because when we go from U to A, arrow goes down. If you go from A to U, then it is A plus TS equal to U. Right? Now, next relation between G and A. Okay. First, we derive relation between U and H. Second relation between G and H. Third relation is between U and A. Now, relation between A and G. So, now, see this. In this case, what is A to V to P, G? When we go from A to G, arrow goes up. So, it is A plus PV equal to G. If we go from G to A, arrow goes down. So, G minus PV equal to A. So, these are the relations. So, these are the definitions of thermodynamics. After defining these relations, now you can derive, you know, as H is equal to U plus PV. So, at constant pressure, delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta V. Right? So, this is the relation. You know, delta U, pressure is constant, so there is no change in pressure, and volume is delta V equal to delta H. Now, second relation, G equal to H minus TS. So, delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S at constant temperature. Here, it is at constant pressure. Now, A equal to U minus TS. So, it is delta A is equal to delta U minus T delta S. This relation, delta G is equal to delta A plus P delta V. That's it. So, these are the definitions of thermodynamics. First definition is very well, you know, in class 11th thermodynamics. This again in class 11th thermodynamics. These relations are for the higher studies, but you know, the trend is there is one question, at least one or two questions from higher studies. So, you should remember these relations as well. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. Do subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.